There it is. Official.
Might not even last.
MISL fans, good day and welcome into the On Center War Memorial Arena. It's Syracuse and Baltimore. The Blast makes its first road trip of the year to Central New York, and the squad's history is bright. Coach Danny Kelly's club is undefeated at 5-0 in the Salt City. Kickoff moments away, situations in the standings on the line. Hello, friends. Thanks for spending your time with me. I'm John Paul Chunga. With the Silver Knights jockeying for a seat at the playoff table, Coach Tommy Tanner's bunch took a hit on Friday. Syracuse fell 16-14 against the Rochester Lancers behind a pair of goals from Jake Schindler. 42-year-old rookie Mark Sotilli earned the win with 11 saves and a brilliant assist to Andrew Hoxie. Loss dropped the Silver Knights to 7-4 on the year and ended a 9-game winning streak against the Thruway rivals. And with the loss, it also put the Silver Knights 2 games behind the Milwaukee Wave and supplanted them into the 4th position in the MISL standings. As for the Baltimore Blast, they've been having a great season, and on Friday they earned a 14-2 win against the St. Louis Ambush. And as a result of last night's game with the Milwaukee Wave, they are now in 2nd place and just a 1/2 game behind that squad. And it's mostly been that great defense that they've had historically in Baltimore. They've allowed only 43 points against, getting them at a 4.3 points a game average. So first, let's set the table for you in this one. The starting lineups for the Baltimore Blast, who are at 8-2. They're coached by head coach Danny Kelly, who won 3 championships in his Blast player career in a 14-year stint. He's 12-7 in the playoffs, and he leads the defending MISL champions. Starting up front for Izanato Neto, behind him Lucio Gonzaga, Marco Mangione, Steven DeRue, and the captain Mike Lookingland, all ahead of William Van Zela. Kickoff right now, and they'll start with Mike Lookingland dumping it in to the Silver Knights starting on the left side of the field. The Baltimore Blast will be wearing all white with a right stripe down the middle and yellow numerals. The Syracuse Silver Knights will be wearing their classic orange, silver, and black with a silver stripe right down the middle and white and silver numerals with a little black trim on that orange. Starting for the 7-4 Syracuse Silver Knights is the ex-Baltimore Blast player, Michelle Millwood, number 23. He played in 182 games for the Blast, scored 174 goals. On the restart, though, it's shot off, taken away. All the way back, Lucio Gonzaga. Back to Mike Lookingland, who will give us an opportunity to finish up those starters for you. In the midfield, Slavisa Ubiparapovic, and the Silver Knights' leading scorer, Canardo Forbes, with 40 points on the year. The defense of the captain, Nelson Santana, and Bo Yelovich, all in front of the keeper, Brian O'Quinn. So now we're allowed to pick up the action. Now Diego Zunaga brings up a foul, and he'll give the ball up on a long shot by Gonzaga. Goes wide, and it's a foul here on Diego Zunaga. Right in front of Brian O'Quinn's goal. 14:02 left in the first quarter. So it'll be a goalkeeper distribution for Brian O'Quinn. He'll hurl it out. Steven DeRue intercepts, and he'll bring it up the left channel. A little poke ahead. And Brian O'Quinn will take it and scoop it up. O'Quinn's having a fine year so far. Near the tops in the league in save percentage at 78. Now the ball's held by Nate Bordeaux. Gives it up to Marco Chantel. Trying to go deep to Neto right there. And he pushed him off. And he'll pick up the foul on the defending MISL Defender of the Year. Defending defender. He does a lot, Mike Lookingland. He sends the ball all the way up to Adriano Dos Santos. Gives it up to Giroux. Back wide to Pat Healy, and he gives it right back. Cutting ball to the center, but it finds no one as Lovisa Ubiparapovic is able to distribute to Neto, who takes a touch out wide. He's got Elenio making a run up the right channel, but he'll opt to bring it back and keep possession with Lovisa Ubiparapovic. Back to Toby, who's back from visiting his family in his native Trinidad. Posting up is Ubiparapovic, looking for a turn on his left foot. Can't fire the trigger, and now it'll be Michelle Millwood. Cutting path. Toby takes a blast, and it goes off the boards. Kicking the ball ahead. Now it'll be taken by Slavisa Ubiparapovic to go all the way to O'Quinn. Michelle Millwood, the ex-Blast player on the ball right now. 10th year professionally. Played 9 of those with the Baltimore Blast. And won 4 MISL champions. On the ground, it's Millwood battling with it. His ex-man, William Vanzella. And they exchange pleasantries on the ground right there. Vanzella, the 2013 playoffs MVP in the championship run that Michelle Millwood was a part of. It's with Vanzella right now. The Italian futsal international. He'll get the ball back from Doru and cling it up the left side, finding Adato Neto as it goes through. He'll blast it off the boards. It'll be scooped up by Brian O'Quinn. 11:45 in the first period. We're still scoreless at zeros. The Blast and the Syracuse Silver Knights. Let's head on the far side to Bo Yelovich. Bring it to the center as the Knights make a change with his defensive pairing. It'll be Toby and Chantel now coming in for Yelovich and Santana. Neto commands the ball in the corner. Picks up another foul, his second early in this one. That'll be a restart for this Baltimore Blast team. Vanzella, long pass to Diego Zunaga. Goes over the boards for a restart on this near side. Today's officials, lead referee Rich Grady, Brian Miller, and John Barbuto, all with Clyde Best in the box. Fouled right there by Adriano Dos Santos is number 99, Slavisa Ubiparapovic, with a nice skill check going between the legs. It'll be a restart just behind the yellow line, and it'll go to Chantel, who will take a long shot, ringing off the barrier. It's cleared away to Zunaga by Looking Land. They'll go back, and the triangle pass will find Adriano Dos Santos, who had 2 goals in the St. Louis Ambush victory. He'll loft it long, and it'll be a 3-line pass, allowing the Silver Knights to have an opportunity in their offensive zone. Nelson approaches. He'll blast it and a save right in the hands of William Vanzella. That's what allowed him to keep his spot as one of the best goalkeepers in MISL. He gives up the distribution, and now it'll be Lucio Gonzaga, stolen away by Canardo Forbes. He'll dump it in. Finding Dos Santos, who will post up with Yelovich clinging onto his back and trying to defend. Poke away by Santana to Canardo Forbes, the Silver Knights scoring leader. Clinging it and skill checking it all the way back to Nelson Santana. He'll go up the right channel, send it across to Bo Yelovich. Ball will go to Canardo Forbes, who wants to be on the ball. Right now he gives it away there. But he's been held scoreless for 2 straight games. The first 2 games he's been held with a donut on the score sheet as he has led this Silver Knights attack with 15 goals. But they've dried up right now, and he'll have a sturdy test against this experienced Baltimore Blast defense that enjoys getting 5 men behind the ball. The leader of it, Mike Lookingland, takes a blast, but it rings off of his own player, Drew Yates. Pushed away by Chantel as now the ball's dumped into the corner, and it's scooped out by Bordeaux, but only to Stephen Drew gives it away cheaply. Corey Alenio driving. He's got Nate Bordeaux with him in the front. His blast is ringing off Lookingland, who picks up another block. It's what he'll do as the defending MISL Defender of the Year. Ubi Parapovic on a little scoop, gives it away. And he'll go for the Baltimore blast. Ball out wide. Pat Healy gives it up and sends it long. Tony Donatelli takes a shot and it rings off the boards. It's now held up by the blast as it couldn't be possessed by the Silver Knights. Cutting pass, poked away by Canardo Forbes, who's doing the dirty work. Santana has it, and he'll go to Forbes. Santana will have it. And approaching on 8 minutes, we're still scoreless with the Silver Knights and Blast here at the On Center War Memorial Arena. No opportunities to speak of that have been especially dangerous so far. Still a cagey affair in the first period here. Ball poked ahead, and now Vanzela will take it away. Held up in a long pass, trying to find Max Ferdinand, their points leader. He couldn't find it, and Corey Alenio with a bright idea trying to find the cultured foot of Neto, who's returned and is now out of the bench. Little shimmy by Max Ferdinand. He'll take a blast, but LJ Papaleo comes in and gets a quick block. That'll take us to our first media timeout. 7:20 to go in the first period. Baltimore Blast and Syracuse Silver Knights tied at zero. We'll be back with more Silver Knights play-by-play on YouTube. Back inside the On Center War Memorial Arena, Syracuse Silver Knights, Baltimore Blast, tied at zeros. When I walk on by, it's 7:20 in the first quarter. No big chances to speak of so far. But right here on a restart, Baltimore Blast have it. Mike Lookingland and Max Ferdinand standing over the ball. Ferdinand will take a shot, and it'll be taken away by Michelle Millwood. Trying to get through is Canardo Forbes, but Daru shields him off, and he'll have an opportunity to hold it. Brings it up. Adato Neto, give a go to Lookingland. Post off the boards by O'Quinn, and he'll have the ball for a distribution. He gives it up cheaply to Diego Zunaga. All the way back to Vanzela, who has quick feet, as Canardo Forbes was sprawling there. Forbes leaving it loose was Dos Santos. Trying to poke it away was the Jamaican. He couldn't get it. He goes all the way back to his goalkeeper. Long pass up, and he'll find the feet of Adriano Dos Santos, who will hold it for the Baltimore Blast. One thing that you may see from this Baltimore team really okay with slowing up the pace, allowing themselves to defend and attack. Goes just wide of O'Quinn's goal. Ball held back and sent in. Taken away by Bojelovic. He's one-on-one with Pat Healy. He'll curl on his left, trying to go against the green. Jelovic again. Blast is saved twice by William Van Zella. That's what's held William Van Zella to an 80% save percentage, just allowing a sub 5 points per game. Santana with it on the near side. He'll give it up. Now the ball trying to escape into the Syracuse offensive third. Can't find it, and now the Blast continue to hold the ball and try to develop opportunities, which have been few and far between so far. Tony Donatelli sends it in. He had 2 goals against the St. Louis Ambush in their last game Friday. It's up for Millwood, the ex-Baltimore man. He's trying to find Slavisa Ubiparapovic, but he couldn't. Derue taken down by Canardo Forbes. He argues the foul, as it would have led to a good opportunity for Slavisa Ubiparapovic on his deadly left foot. Still 0-0 inside the War Memorial, with less than 5 minutes to go. As now LJ Papaleo checks into the game, the Syracuse native, and he picks up the foul immediately.
Michael Roberts and Associates, your local source for independent.
And sitting at 7-4 for the Syracuse Silver Knights, 11-20th through the season. And you know, if you listen to the Men in Blazers, oh, right there! LJ Papaleo on the header! He finishes it! And with 5 goals on the year, he nets it! Knights up 2-0. Out of a long ball from Brian O'Quinn, LJ Papaleo rises high and finds the back of the net with a quick snap header. With 4:24 left in the first quarter, Silver Knights up 2-0. Shot right there ringing off the top on Brian O'Quinn. Now the ball will go to Adato Neto. Goes to the near side to JT Noon. And now Pat Healy will hold it and bang it off the boards, trying to find Adato Neto, the former Syracuse Salty Dog. Played here right in the Salt City. Long shot and scooped over the top by Pat Healy. Now go out for a goalkeeper distribution from Brian O'Quinn. But with less than 4 minutes to go, the Silver Knights finally have a lead. 2-0 after that LJ Papaleo snap header. It's held by Neto on the far side, finding Slavisa Ubiparapovic. Can't look for Coriolanio as he's dispossessed by Looking Land, but he gets it right back, and now it's with Neto on the far side. Shadowed by JT Noon. Gives it up for Jelovic. Slavisa Ubiparapovic. The boards and down for Neto. The other Neto takes it away. And now a long clearance is taken by the Syracuse Silver Knights. 3 minutes to go. The Knights lead 2-0. It's held with Neto, who wants to turn, but he gives it right back to Marco Chantel, and he'll reload with Darren Toby in the back. Wide to Canardo Forbes. And now Chantel will hold it. The Brazilian gives it up to the Jamaican Michelle Millwood. The ex-Blast player guarded by his teammate Steven Derue. Now will give it up to Brian O'Quinn, who will be content to hold with it. What a point that I was about to give up was that 11-20 through the season, the Syracuse Silver Knights are 7-4 and really poised to make their first playoffs appearance in their three-year history. As right now, sitting behind them, St. Louis and the Rochester Lancers, both with 4 wins on the year, Syracuse Silver Knights expected to be better in year 3. And right now at 7-4, they are. Canardo Forbes now with possibilities. He's cutting it against the grain, going to Michelle Millwood, but he can't find the mark. And now it'll be Lucio Gonzaga on a 3v3. Off the boards, scooped out by Domenico Vitale, and pinged forward by Canardo Forbes. With 1:20 to go, the Knights lead the Blast 2-0 in the first quarter. On an LJ Papaleo snap down header, just over the hands of William Vanzella. It's chipped into the boards, but now taken away by a smooth defensive move by Bo Yelovich. Slavisa Ubiparapovic trying to go on a skill check through the defender of the year. Couldn't come off, and he gives the ball away. JT Noon, ball off the walls. To Healy, trying to give it right back. Ball shot on the ground, and it's scooped up by Brian O'Quinn on the Lucas Roque shot. Corellanio with it. As right now, with 15 seconds to go, Knights are looking for one last opportunity in the first period. Holding against the walls and harassing him was Adato Neto. Corellanio picks up the foul. Held up, and now with 3 seconds to go, 1 second, Neto trying to take a shot on goal. He can't. And that's 15 minutes of soccer. After that period, the Syracuse Silver Knights lead 2-0 over the Baltimore Blast, the reigning MISL champions. Back to Silver Knights soccer on YouTube after this for second quarter action.
Phone damage? Don't be without your phone. Come to Cell Phones for Less for... Phone damage? Don't be without your phone. Come to Cell Phones for Less for same-day repair. We fix cell phones, iPads, and iPads. We have the largest selection of new and used phones in upstate New York. Cell Phones for Less in Eastwood and our new location in Destiny, USA.
Teams will switch sides. It's now the Syracuse Silver Knights will attack right to left across your screen. The Baltimore Blast will attack left to right. The squad of Millwood, Bojelovic, Nelson Santana, Slavisa Ubiparapovic, and Kenardo Forbes on the field. As the Salt City supporters section is happy after that first period, leading 2-0 on an LJ Papaleo goal. The native boy scored his fifth of the year, put him on 12 points for his rookie season. Drew on the ball right now, gives it up to Vanzela. Poke it ahead to Adriano Dos Santos. He scored 2 goals against St. Louis in the last time out. Drew will hold. He had an assist in that game. He'll receive the back pass, trying to cut it across Bojelovic, but he couldn't, and he'll take a blast. It'll ring right off of Michelle Millwood. They'll count that as a 3-line pass, and it'll go to the center of the yellow line for a restart. One thing that Coach Tommy Tanner was not happy about was restart defense, and we've talked about it on these streams all year. Max Ferdinand will play it in. Trying to find and connect with it looks like Roque. Millwood will box out Pat Healy, who will fall to the ground. Millwood will keep the ball. Right in front, it's Lucas Roque. He's taken down. There'll be an opportunity right there as Nelson Santana pleads his case. It's the first foul, it looks like, for Nelson Santana, which always is a great sign if you're a Silver Knights fan, that Nelson Santana isn't picking up those early fouls. He's had a knack of finding himself in the box, leading to the most penalty minutes for him as a defender. Rich Grady will back up the wall as the restarts on the left side of Brian O'Quinn's goal. Standing over it is the captain, Looking Land. Encroaching is the wall, but they won't bring it back. Shot rings in the back of the net, and we're tied. The captain, Mike Looking Land, scores his 7th on the year and evens the scoring. Mike Lookingland went top shelf on that score to beat Brian O'Quinn, who could not see it. He was screened by his wall as he cheated a little to his right. A ball flew right past his left ear and touched the back of the net. But again, that dangerous free kick given up by the captain, Nelson Santana. All chipped up by Darren Toby, and now Neto will control it. Give it up. The Blast have it right now. Toby returning after his solid play has been really beneficial for the Knights. As Tommy Tanner calls him one of those quiet leaders on the field that he enjoys relying on. Toby back after missing 2 games for the Knights. Ball swings back to Lucio Gonzaga. And the Blast will slow up the pace. Close to 12:30 left in the second quarter, we're even after a Mike Lookingland strike on a restart. All sent up. Now Pat Healy will get it wide and cuts it across back to Healy. Peeling for a handball, can't get it. This ball's clipped up by Lucio Gonzaga. Santana will bring it down. He'll move the ball and go 1v1. He doesn't look for passes right there. He'll chase as he's got loads of energy. Blass will get it around him, and his running is fruitless. He'll check out of the game, though, for Nate Bordeaux. Long pass into the corner for Lucas Roque. He gets a turn, but Toby recovers and takes it away. It bounces off the referee in the corner, and it's held for a little scrum. Out of there comes Zunaga, and he did it with an infraction. 11:27 to go in the second quarter. We're tied at twos. Now Canardo Forbes will give it up to Marco Chantel on the far side, trying to cut it down for Nate Bordeaux. Down the line, it's poked away by Zunaga. Now Brian O'Quinn will clip it up for LJ Papaleo. Ball knocked down and Canardo Forbes collects. Bordeaux to Yelovich. Across the body. Gives up to his defensive partner, Marco Chantel. Long blast, way too far. He'll go out for a restart. Chantel will jump out of the game, and local boy Domenico Vitali will check in. The ex-Lemoyne Dolphin. Domenico Vitali also plays outdoor soccer for the Albany Black Watch. Greater Binghamton FC, but the ball held up. LJ Papaleo gives it up, rather Canardo Forbes to Michelle Millwood. It proves fruitless as the X-Blast player had himself 1v1 with the goalkeeper, but couldn't get a shot on goal. A poor effort. Does really need an opportunity. When you're 1v1 against the Blast, they don't switch off too often. The Silver Knights will have an upper opportunity on the right side of Vanzilla's goal, just in front of the three-point arc, for a restart on a Steven Giroux handball. A two-man wall for Canardo Forbes to look at. Approaches, goes to Yelovich, bangs it off of Giroux, and it'll clang out of bounds off of a fan. And it'll go out for a Baltimore Blast restart, which I'm not sure it is. Look to bang off of a Baltimore defender. Either way, he'll go for the Blast. Lookingland to Max Ferdinand. Forbes defending, and he'll take it away. On the near side. Back heel finding Michelle Millwood. The league's second man in assists. Bo Yelovich on a long touch. He'll poke it ahead, trying to get an opportunity on Vanzela. But the goalkeeper calmly picks it up and distributes. Cutting across is Drew Yates. Long blast by Lookingland goes safely into the palms of Brian O'Quinn. Held by Bordeaux. Now Toby will get it. The Baltimore bench screaming for an infraction on the Silver Knights, as they believe they had a sloppy substitution. Danny Kelly incensed on the bench right there. Still drawing with the officials. It's in the far corner for Neto. He's trying to turn, but he's down on the ground as he finds himself with DeRue as a partner on the turf. Swings around the horn to Corey Elenio, guarded by Gonzaga. He shadows him, and we'll have to give up to Darren Toby. On his preferred left foot, gives it up to Chantel. Bangs into Neto, who's on the ground, as is DeRue. Second time they've done that on this possession. It goes out only to Elenio. Reloading time for the Syracuse Silver Knights, and it's in for Neto. Still guarded by DeRue. They're going to become friends after this one, as it seems to be DeRue's job to mark that target forward. Ringing shot by Slavisa Ubiparapovic causes a bruise on a blast defender. It'll be held in by the Knights. Jelovic going in. The chant is yes, let's go Knights. Held up by Corey Elenio, and it's dispossessed. All the way back for Ubiparapovic to hold up by Brian O'Quinn. The crowd urging for the Knights to attack. Jelovic holds into the middle for Canardo Forbes. Posting up is Michelle Millwood, and knocked away by Looking Land. Couldn't clear as Canardo Forbes still has it. Lollipops it over the defender. But it's taken away by the defender of the year. He's knocked away, and now the Baltimore Blast have an opportunity. On this near side, it's Drew Yates, the DeMatha product. Long shot by Roque, can't find it. And now a 3v2 developing the other way. Pulled down by Pat Healy was Michelle Millwood, and we'll have our first penalty of the game. As you see the Salt City supporters enjoying that call. As Pat Healy grabbed a hold of Michelle Millwood as he was streaking down for a 3v2 opportunity. Pat Healy brought him down and picks up the 2 minutes. 7:08 to go in the second quarter. We're tied at twos after LJ Papaleo opened the scoring with his fifth goal. And then Mike Lookingland on a restart, even the game. But before we take this restart, we'll take a break. Back to Silver Knight Soccer on YouTube after this. Macaroni, spaghetti, meatballs. No! .08 to go in the second period. The Knights and Blast are tied at twos. And if you enjoy watching major indoor soccer league action, keep checking along on the YouTube pages of these teams. And for score, stats, news, and more, check out exclusively all of that on MISL.com. Get the latest from around the league and follow MISL Soccer on Twitter at MISL Soccer. Bernardo Forbes on the restart now. He'll take a long shot that flashes over the top of the goal. Doesn't concern Van Zela. Dos Santos with it. It's corralled by Nelson Santana on a little kick check. Takes the ball away. Using all of his experience. Millwood will hold the ball to Canardo Forbes. He'll give it up for Slavisa Ubiparapovich. Around the horn for Millwood. He'll clip it in, trying to find Neto. It'll go down, and we'll have a foul right on the three-point line as Neto takes a dive on the turf. Millwood will have this restart with his left foot off the boards and clanged in front by Looking Land. Ubiparapovich has the rebound. But DeRue expertly takes the ball away. And on a grab by Ubiparapovich, he'll send it in. Knights still with that advantage on this run of play with 1:10 left in the power play for Pat Healy. Syracuse Silver Knights are second in the league in power play efficiency at 37%, going 7-for-19. But the Blast are first in the penalty kill at 86%. Long drive by Canardo Forbes. Goes off the barrier, and it's time to reload with O'Quinn. 40 seconds left on the power play. Millwood will be on the field with Canardo Forbes. He'll give it to him. Now send in for Santana. Wide to Ubiparapovich. Canardo Forbes winds up and fires. Bangs off of DeRue. He'll go out for another restart. On these power plays, look for Nelson Santana. He leads the league in power play goals with 3. Ball held up and taken away. 10 seconds to go in this. And a foul picked up right there. Done by Michelle Millwood. 5 seconds left in the penalty, and now Pat Healy is allowed to come on, and it's killed by the Blast. Millwood with it. Gives it back to Santana, back to Millwood. Takes a strike, kick saved by Fanzela. Will be headed out by Looking Land.
Let's go, Knights! Let's
Santana
go, Knights. Let's
to
go,
Jelovic. To the target man, Millwood. He's corralled by Looking Land as he wasn't even allowed to turn for that ball. Pushed ahead to Noon, who gives it back to Healy and all the way back to Vanzela. Plays catch with Healy. Down the line for Adato Neto, guarded by Chantel. He's got options in the middle. Pushes off Chantel Adato. Goes wide to Diego Zunaga. Hangs off of a defender, and it finds the hands of Brian O'Quinn. On the near side, Bojelovic cutting in on the right with his bright orange shoes. To the lime greens of Coriolanium. LJ Papaleo on it, the goal scorer. And the ball will escape his touch for William Vanzela to hurt. Ball goes wide, and now Coriolanio will have it and look for Neto. Shielded away by JT Noon, and it goes back to his goalkeeper. As we're tied at 2s with 3:30 to go in the second period, after an LJ Papaleo opening goal for the Syracuse Silver Knights, Mike Looking Land equalized for the Blast. Nelson Santana with it. He'll take it. A pass to Neto, whose shot is blocked away. Back to Toby and the far side for Canardo Forbes. Rolling with a little crawls to the center of the field. Go wide. Slavisa Ubiparapovich drives. Gives it up to Forbes. And down, chipped in for Neto. Cutting across. A shot by Canardo Forbes. Now get dumped in to the Silver Knights bench with coach Tommy Tanner and assistant Joe Papaleo. Ball off the boards by Neto. I'll take it. into the hands. Ball on the near side for Drew Yates. Centering to Max Ferdinand. Through the legs of Bojelovic by Adriano Dos Santos, but couldn't find a teammate. Closing in on 2 minutes left in this half. Tied at twos. Held in right now and poked away by Slavisa Ubiparapovic. Foul on the near side for Coriolanio. Lucio Gonzaga earns it. Hold on, Gonzaga will hold the ball. Ping it back to Mike Lookingland. Clipped in for Odato Neto. He's got the inside on Bojelovic. But Jelovic has a strong leg. Gives it a little poke away. He'll have to earn position back. Lookingland on a little touch. Goes back to Neto. And he'll receive the pass back. Playing catch now. He'll receive the back pass. Poked away by LJ Papaleo. And Jelovic will have the ball. Nice sliding challenge by Adato. We'll have the ball. And now the Blast can possess with 1 minute to go in the second period. Tied at twos. Holding up is Roque. He'll take a shot as he got the inside track on Coriolanio. He'll go over the top for goalkeeper distribution. O'Quinn hurls. Looking for the target man, Michelle Millwood. Darren Toby will collect, and now Nelson Santana has it. Taken away by Diego Zunaga. And all the way back to Vanzela. Long pass by Donatelli. Reload with the Temple University product. Tony gives it up for Zunaga. Cutting in on his left. Gets it back and now goes to JT Noon. Cutting it across to the center. Diego Zunaga gets the ball off on a couple pings. And that'll be the half. 30 minutes of soccer have been played. And if you like offense, well, there wasn't much of it. Syracuse Silver Knights and Baltimore Blast are tied at twos. After a half of soccer that saw LJ Papaleo open the scoring on a smooth header with 4 minutes to go in the first quarter. But to open the second period, Mike Lookingland scored on a restart that ringed past the ears of Brian O'Quinn. We'll be back for the third and fourth quarter of this matchup, but enjoy halftime. As for this halftime, we'll be having the media halftime game for the Syracuse Silver Knights.
Thinking technology and connectivity? Think the new 2014 Chevy Cruze with 2 years scheduled maintenance. Now get $1,500 cash back or lease Cruze for just $149 a month at your central New York Chevy dealer, cnychevy.com.
After this. two quarters to go. Knights and Blast tied at two. And who would have known that there would be more scoring in the media game than the actual game? Two goals for Team Buster took the media game over Team Dave. I've got to say, I'm pretty upset at that loss in the media game. Definitely could have seen me in the blue shorts, ranging up and down the side. And I'll put this one on myself. No need to blame Wayne Mahar or Syracuse.com's Def Jeff in that one. I lost my mark on the game-winning goal, and Team Busters took it. We were a nice blast. Three goals in that one, just two in the actual game. The opener scored with 4 minutes to go in the first quarter by LJ Papaleo, and the second goal of the game scored just 2 minutes into the opening of the second quarter by Mike Lookingland on a restart. And now we are right where we are, 2-2, the Silver Knights and Blast, with 30 minutes to go in the game. And we're starting with the third quarter, as this one has had a pretty slow and drawn out pace throughout. The Blast have been playing their game of defensive soccer, and so far it's worked against the run and gun Syracuse Silver Knights. We're underway for the second 15, the third 15 rather, of the game. Tied at twos, the Syracuse Silver Knights and Baltimore Blast. Mike Lookingland holds, gives it up to William Van Zela. Now we'll send it in over the top for a long chip. Blast off the post by Adato Neto, and it'll go over the top on a follow-up header by Marco Mangione. Ball held up in the crowd, and now we'll have a break in the action. A goalkeeper distribution from Brian O'Quinn. Long by Neto. Now Nate Bordeaux with control. Diego Zanaga. Back to Pat Healy. Long chip ahead and headed by Marco Chantel. Coriolano will turn. He's got the option of Neto. He was looking for Neto right there, but the Brazilian didn't finish his run. Held back and drawn down. Dos Santos, and that'll send Marco Chantel to the box. He knew he was beaten for speed by Dos Santos, and he had to grab him. So he'll head to the box for the first 2 minutes for the Syracuse Silver Knights, their first visit to the sin bin in this one. They'll go on the penalty kill, where this team has been just above average, the third team in MISL in killing penalties at 80%. And that's where the Baltimore Blast sit on the power play at 36%, going 4 of 11 on the man-up advantages. And this is the preferred penalty kill for the Syracuse Silver Knights in Antonio Manfoot, Darren Toby, Domenico Vitali, and Bo Yelovich. Darren Toby had been out for a couple games visiting his family and attending affairs in Trinidad. And now that he's back, Coach Tommy Tanner can look to his preferred penalty kill unit. The Blast will counter with Lucio Gonzaga, Mike Lookingland, Tony Donatelli, Adato Neto, and Max Ferdinand. It's taken up by Manfoot. Pokes away by Lookingland. He'll bring it in. 2v2 with Adato Neto. Trying to center it is the Brazilian. He'll give it up for Mike Lookingland, who will take a blast, and it'll go out all the way to Max Ferdinand as it couldn't connect. Lookingland will hold it. Feed into this central spot for Max Ferdinand. Deep play in for Lucio Gonzaga. Lookingland will possess and send it back up. 1 minute encroaching on this penalty kill now. They've killed off 1 minute. 13 to go in the third quarter. Tied at twos. Syracuse Silver Knights and Baltimore Blast. Looking land will hold it with 50 seconds on the man advantage. It goes across the goal and finds Adato Neto on the rebound. He'll loft it up on a deft touch. It's Looking Land. He'll swing it across to Lucio Gonzaga. Back to Looking Land. Shifting the diamond. Saren Toby as he guards Looking Land. Goes to the wide side for Neto, who takes a volley. And it's just wide of Brian O'Quinn's goal. He'll go to the wide centering pass. Blocked away on the Max Ferdinand shot. Looking Land will hold. 20 seconds to go on the power play. Stolen away by Antonio Manfoot. And it'll be poked away. Held in by Donatelli. Adato Neto on the far side. He'll blast it in the far post. And the former Syracuse Salty Dogs forward has scored. His sixth on the year. And gives the Blast a 4-2 advantage. Only the fifth time that the Baltimore Blast have scored on the power play, but it gives the squad the lead at 4-2 with 12:15 to go in the third quarter. Adato Neto. That has to be sweet for the 2006 MISL MVP. He's a mainstay here in New York, as he was a former Rochester Rhino and Syracuse Salty Dog. Ball held up by Dos Santos, trying to cross it over to Nelson Santana. Rather, is dispossessed by Santana, and Dos Santos can't connect. But Adato Neto scoring in places familiar. He made 19 appearances in the Salt City and tallied one goal. Right now, he has the game-changing goal. 11:41 to go in the third quarter, up 4-2. It was a smart shot, as the Syracuse Silver Knights were getting a little loose on their rotations in the diamond. It was taken away. Coriolano has it. He looks up for Michelle Millwood one-on-one. Poked away by JT Noon, or rather Pat Healy, and he'll send it up the boards. Pat Healy has it 1v1. He can't fire the trigger. It goes off of the Syracuse Silver Knights defender, and it'll be a safe escape for the Syracuse Silver Knights, as it was helter-skelter defending at the back. Somehow, some way, Brian O'Quinn didn't face a shot on goal, that is. And it went over the top for no dice. 11-11 to go in the third quarter. Blast up by two. Coriolano has it, and after he's taken down, he keeps possession. Earns the foul on Mike Lookingland. And the Syracuse Silver Knights can now get in numbers on their own offensive zone. And with that goal, it's equaled the total in the media game at 3 goals in the game so far. But they've got a lot more time than the press, as they've got 25 minutes to go. Long blast by Bo Yelovich. He likes scoring from deep. He'll have it right here. Want to cut it on his right. He does. Finds the top of the post, and it rings William Van Zella, as he did nothing to stop that one. Put it an inch lower, and it's in. Now it's off the far boards to Neto. In front, Nate Bordeaux caught under his feet as he couldn't fire the shot. He had it 1v1 with William Van Zella and no defenders in front. It's on the far side for JT Noon, and it's taken away on a poke by Marco Chantel. Nelson Santana will find Darren Toby on the right channel as the Silver Knights attack from left to right. Michelle Millwood trying to back in. Scoop off Nelson Santana on the give. But a smart poke check by a glass defender gets it in the safe paws of William Vanzella. Chested down by Saliza Ubiparapovic. Canardo Forbes on his preferred right foot! He scores! He'll break his two-game scoreless drought right there with 9:37 in the third quarter. And he'll earn himself a tied game. The 16th from the Jamaican moves him to 42 points on the year. But we'll take a look at this to see if it was a three-point goal. As he looked like it was edging in on two-point territory, but with the review, he gives the Knights the lead. As on first glance, it looked a little too close to determine whether it was a three-point goal from the naked eye. They check it quickly, and that's why they're allowed instant replay. And the Knights have the lead at 5-4. With 9:30 to go, the Syracuse Silver Knights have a one-point lead on that Canardo Forbes blast. So now he has 43 points on the season, besting last year's effort from him. Bojelovic gives it up to Papaleo on the far side, trying to fizz it across the goal to Corey Alenia, who made a run to the center. And it was evading the ex-Columbus Crew member. Goes to Diego Zunaga. Back to Adriano Dos Santos, finding a man in front, but it goes just wide of the goal. In front, taken on a poor giveaway by the Silver Knights. And Pat Healy scores his third on the year and gives the Blast a 6-5 advantage. As the ball was centered in front, the initial shot was over the top, and Marco Chantel couldn't handle it. As he tried to head it back to Brian O'Quinn, but the ball was right out of the goalkeeper's grasp. And the ball caromed off of a defender, found its way to Pat Healy's foot, and he scored his third goal of the year to give him 10 points for the campaign. The son of Blast president and GM Kevin Healy, Pat earns himself a lead for the Blast at 6-5 with 8:30 to go in the third quarter. Finally, some offense in this one. They took some hints from the media members, started to score some goals. As the ball's down here with Canardo Forbes, but a foul given to the Baltimore Blast as Neto was on the ground and apparently infringed on a Blast defender. So the ball here with the Blast with 8 minutes to go. Deft touch by Neto. Taken away by O'Quinn as he was active straight off his line. He read the play and took it away from the former Salty Dog and defended it well. Down on the ground goes Nelson Santana, and in the eyes of the official, it was due to a Dato Neto back challenge.
It is Salty. It's T-shirt time. T-shirt time.
It's T-shirt
time. Everybody knows it's T-shirt time. T-shirt time. It's T-shirt time.
T-shirt time.
It's T-shirt time. Everybody knows it's T-shirt time. T-shirt time.
It's T-shirt time.
Everybody knows it's T-shirt time.
Shot off a Blast defender and over the top into the netting. And with that, we'll have a timeout on the floor. Knights trail by one with 7:07 in the third quarter. We'll be back
Dreams.
With more Syracuse Silver Knights play-by-play on on YouTube.
We dream of what our life could be, what it should be. We dream about all the possibilities. The possibilities that we could go to college, that we could get that perfect job, that we could buy a new house. The possibility we could become great. But becoming great isn't easy. It's not something we can fall into. It takes courage, determination. It takes a plan. It takes help and guidance from people you trust who can lead you in the right direction. Dreams. Every day we dream of becoming great. So get out there and find a partner that you can trust who can lead you through the game of life to greatness. Reach your dreams with Salve Bank.
Back inside the on-center War Memorial Arena. The Silver Knights down by one with 7:07 to go in the third quarter. After it's been an active third frame for the two sides, equaling the first scoring in the first half. Here with two goals. One a three-pointer by Canardo Forbes and the other a touch-up goal by Pat Healy on the smooth rebound collection score. Knights have the ball. On the corner, sets up for Millwood. Long shot on the ground was Healy to block it. It goes over the top. And it'll be a corner on the far side. So Ubi Parapovic will stand over it. Sets up Canardo Forbes on the exact same corner kick try that they did before. Except with Millwood on the other corner. Millwood will hold the ball. Now the ball's pinged all the way back to O'Quinn. Bojelovic cutting in on to the center, but on his left, and he wants to keep it on his preferred right. The crowd clamors, "Let's go Knights!" Chantel will hold. Back to Toby. Swings it near side to Forbes. He'll dump it in for Neto off the barrier, and he'll hold. Pin it against the wall. The referees will want it on the ground. Now the officials will sort out what to do with it. Looks like it'll be a drop ball. It will, and it'll be taken out by Mike Lookingland. Out in front to Chantel. All the way back to the goalkeeper, O'Quinn. Centering pass to Nate Bordeaux. Ball played in front for Lookingland. Bangs it off the boards. Find the top to Max Ferdinand. Ferdinand, ball held up, and Chantel will get it. Feed ahead, and now only to Toby. And then a little volley will go to Lookingland. Plays the 2011 World Championship Goalkeeper of the Year in futsal. Ball taken away by Corey Elenio. Now will give it away to Diego Zunaga. Ahead for Neto, whose touch eludes him, and he's taken out wide on the boards. He'll hold up, and now he'll take a tumble. Nobody in front. As now Santana's able to collect up the field. Ball poked away by Max Ferdinand. Slavisa Ubi Parapovic wanting to go on his left, but Diego Zunaga knew it. Guard against it. Now the Blast are able to get into their shell of five men behind the ball. Organized in it. Wide to Jelovic. Corey Elenio cuts into the middle. Goes to the point for Slavisa Ubi Parapovic. Little dump into Michelle Millwood. Holds against the boards, but he's double teamed gets the ball taken away. Trying to do a skill check was Ubi Parapovich. He gets the ball taken away. Long pass ahead for Max Ferdinand. He'll want a blast, but Ubi Parapovich gets back defensively. He'll hold up the play, and Max Ferdinand has to go to looking land. Touch in to the target man, Adato Neto, and Millwood will get it. Pushed away by his former teammate, Neto, who slides on the ground, and it'll be a foul on the forward. So we'll have another foul on him. With under four to go, the Silver Knights down by one. Neto bangs it off the boards, but nobody was making a run in front. The ball is wasted. Now the Blast have the ball, but they quickly give it away. Very un-Baltimore-like right there, as they cheaply give it away. Nervous moments for the Knights there as Brian O'Quinn is holding the ball and passing with a defender on the far side. Long pass diagonally by Canardo Forbes, flies outside. And the Blast will have the ball at the top of the arc. Another restart for Mike Lookingland, who scored his seventh goal of the year, his second in his weekend. On the earlier restart in the second quarter, he'll opt for a timeout as the Blast look to draw up a play on this one. And with the timeout on the floor, we'll take one too. You're listening to Silver Knights play-by-play on YouTube. Inside the War Memorial Arena, a restart for the Baltimore Blast at the top of the arc with Mike Lookingland over it. Three in the wall as the ball goes on the left side, shot wide over the top by Tony Donatelli. Whipped in by Lookingland and over the top, it's wasted. Up here as the ball was caught into the netting, and Bo Yelovich will stand over the ball and thump it long for the head of Michelle Millwood. His target pass goes to Elenio. He'll collect on the board, chip it up Zunaga. Nelson Santana gives up Slavisa Ubiparapovich. Ubiparapovich on a double team is able to get the ball to the bright orange shoes of Bo Yelovich. Long pass into Millwood. He'll control with Pat Healy on his back. Nelson Santana tries to keep it in, but Zunaga's able to collect. Check that as Yelovich has the ball. Outside flick for Elenio is no good, and he'll go through the legs, but taken away by Lucas Roque and his purple shoes. Lookingland with his lime greens plays it ahead. Held up. by Marco Mangione. And now the ball pings out for Adato Neto. Dispossessed as Elenio gets it to Ubi Parapovic. He'll try to scoop through, but no good. Ball sent out. Nelson Santana will give it up. Looking Land has possibilities. He'll take a left-footed shot. Rings off of the top of the board and goes right down. Rebound in front. Not collected by Tony Dalatelli. He'll kick it off the barrier, and he'll go out for Looking Land. Another blast. And a save diving to his right, Brian O'Quinn. O'Quinn sees his team needs a little break. He'll take a timeout. And with 1:33, the Blast have developed more opportunities.
I'm a hot babe out jogging. I'm not making sure this stays a 10 when you drive by. You're checking out my awesome headband when... Oops. That's when you find out your cut rate insurance, it ain't paying for this. So get Allstate. Save cash and be better protected from mayhem, like me.
Back inside the War Memorial Arena, the Knights are trailing the Blast by one with 1:33 to go in the third quarter in the first of two meetings in a six-day stretch, as the Knights will go to Maryland on Friday to play Baltimore at Baltimore Arena in the second of four meetings in the final half of their season. In this half of the season, the Knights have five of their remaining eight fixtures at home. Ball shot on by Neto, but he pushed down DeRue, and that'll be a foul right there. But as I brought up before, the Knights are in the fine part of their schedule where they have a majority of their games in front of this home crowd, as that includes fixtures against the Pennsylvania Roar, the Baltimore Blast, Milwaukee Wave, and Rochester Lancers. With only trips to Maryland and Rochester left on the schedule. 11/20 into the MISL season, which if you listen to Men in Blazers, it's not what we like because that fraction doesn't reduce. Ball shot ahead by Millwood as he claims that it clambered off of a Baltimore Blast hand. The referees are unconvinced as Drew Yates seemed to get away from it. Syracuse clamoring for a six men on the field players that is. And they'll stop the game and pick up the blue card on a sloppy change. Tommy Tanner noticed it immediately. The entire bench shouted for it. And now they get it. Looking Land goes for appeals. But it falls on deaf ears. And now Drew Yates, the DeMatha product, will head into the box. Yates was drafted by the Chicago Fire. Didn't play a game with the MLS side. Decided to go to the Charlotte Eagles after a fine career at Maryland, which saw him win the 2008 NCAA title. Ball sent into Neto, and they'll have another power play opportunity as they are 7-for-20 on their man-up advantages. Which again, that fraction doesn't reduce. And Roger Bennett would be pretty upset. With 21 seconds to go in the third quarter, the Blast up by one over the Silver Knights. and 1:53 to go in the sin bin for Drew Yates. Right here, a key opportunity for the Silver Knights to start a comeback against the Blast. Ball poorly played, and Pat Healy's able to head it out. He'll go ahead for Adriano Dos Santos. A key leg by Michelle Millwood denies Dos Santos the opportunity. Healy out in front. He'll be taken down by Nelson Santana, and he'll head to the sin bin as he had to take it out in front. Otherwise, Healy was wide open for another tap-in on a rebound. But it'll be a spot kick for Mike Lookingland as Nelson Santana will go to the box after the Silver Knights were shaky defensively right there. And with 7.5 seconds to go in the third quarter, Mike Lookingland will head to the spot as Nelson Santana heads to the sin bin. The captain will stand over it with all the other players having to wait at the yellow line. O'Quinn right in front of the goal. Lookingland approaches and puts it right down the middle. With 6.8 seconds to go in the period, Mike Lookingland scores his third of the weekend, his eighth on the year, and the defender of the year puts the Blast up 8-5. It was calmly done by the captain as he went right down the middle. Tommy Tanner is obviously very angry right now, going after the official on the far side. He won't receive anything, and the third quarter will look to end as Conardo Forbes drives in. A frustrated Tommy Tanner and a frustrated Syracuse squad ends the third period down by 3. So after all of that action in the third quarter, the Blast lead it 8-5, even though the score board doesn't say it. We'll be back with the final 15 of Major Indoor Soccer League action after this. We're here for the final quarter of this one. 15 minutes on the clock, and the Blast lead the Knights 8-5 after four goals in the third quarter, doubled what we had in the first half. And Baltimore takes a lead by going on a 4-0 run after Canardo forwards put the home side ahead 5-4. And now the Blast lead it. It was a question on the YouTube stream whether Nelson Santana would come out of the box, but apparently he will not, as the refs deem him still in. But Michelle Millwood doesn't care. He will score against his old club. And he'll put the Knights, his new squad, down by one. The X-Blast player scores his ninth for his new squad. And his second on the weekend as he finds the far post, beating his old goalkeeper, William Van Zella. And on the 4v4, the Knights pull within 1 point at 14:44 left to go in the fourth quarter. It was a smart turn by Millwood and an unexpected right-footed shot that found the back of the net. Millwood will look for space here as he had the ball played in front of him, couldn't connect on it on a deft touch. And now the ball's played off the boards and Forbes will control. Missed on that on the whiff. Neto will cut it on his right. Long shot over the top as O'Quinn had a paw if it was on frame. Max Ferdinand takes an ill-advised turn, and Jelovic will have the ball. A 2v2 here. Max Ferdinand coming back defensively. He's stoned by Pat Healy, and he'll run the other way. Slowing the ball up, he'll go to the center to Max Ferdinand, with Adato Neto running the left channel. He's guarded away, and LJ Papaleo has the ball. But it'll take a whistle from the referee, as it looked as if the Knights might be penalized for a sloppy change as LJ Papaleo jumped on the field. They'll hold up as Rich Grady and Brian Miller will discuss this. 53 seconds left on the Nelson Santana penalty box stay, and 31 seconds left on the Drew Yates penalty. After the dust settles, doesn't look as if teams will be penalized. They're still discussing it. Millwood would come over to listen to this, as Michelle Millwood will act as the Knights captain without the armband. And he's taken a big leadership role on the Syracuse Silver Knights as he came over as an experienced player from the Baltimore Blast. He's added some stability to a young team in major indoor soccer. This franchise is just in its third year, hasn't had any playoff experience, and hasn't really had any winning experience, as last year they went 8 wins in a 26-game season. But Michelle Millwood, his 4 championships brought over from the Baltimore Blast, he brings an added veteran spot to this team. And so no penalty enforced. The Knights just down by one and equal with 4-on-4 field players right now. Lucio Gonzaga plays the ball off the boards, looking for a cutting Lucas Roque, and out in front it'll go to Millwood, the long strides, trying to get on the ball, but Mike Lookingland takes it away on a smooth poke. Lucio Gonzaga will hold the ball. Canardo Forbes and LJ Papaleo combine for the takeaway. And off the boards, he'll go to Toby. Holding off Dos Santos is the Trinidadian. And he'll earn himself a foul. Coming down the left channel, Nelson Santana has both penalties are cleared. And now we're playing even strength. Just under 13 minutes. The Knights down by one. LJ Papaleo, the number seven, holds it. He gives it up, and Lucio Gonzaga will hold. Coming back from trailing has been a tricky business for teams who play Baltimore, and down goes Lucio Gonzaga on a foul. Alenio pleads that he went down a little too easily, but it's fine. Looking land to Neto. Feeds DeRue. Far side to Max Ferdinand. Centrally to Looking Land. Down the right channel, DeRue on a step over. Cuts in on his left. Gives it back up to the point man, Looking Land. Near side, DeRue. Pushes ahead for Ferdinand. Taken away by Alenio, who lofts it up only to the calm feet of the captain, who has two goals on the game. Ferdinand, the Blast leading scorer. Looking Land winds up his arms but doesn't fire. And now Neto will take the ball. Looking Land, a blast, can't get it under his feet is Ferdinand. It'll go out in front. Big Bo Jelovic on his right. He takes a smart touch, fizzes it across the goal. Nobody's there in front, and it doesn't test William Van Zela. As it looked to be a one opportunity for the Silver Knights to get a shot on goal with 11:30 to go in the fourth quarter, down by one. Ball will slow up, and Lucas Roque will control. Roque. Sao Paulo, Brazil, he'll have a shot. And Toby will block. Out in front, lashed on it was Drew Yates, but he can't get it to test Brian O'Quinn. Ball on the far side for DeRue. On his left. He'll hold, and Darren Toby will shadow him. Neto at the top as the Blast start to hold this game and put a stranglehold on possession. They like to kill games as Roque cuts in. Oh, a clever handball by Nelson Santana as the Baltimore Blast appeal for it. He's getting harassed by two Blast defenders. Arms waving in his face. He's going at it alone, and the shot doesn't test anyone. Oh, and then Santana takes a dive as Pat Healy put himself in between Santana and his intended march forward. A foul right there. As the Syracuse Silver Knights kind of undisciplined play. They had six players on the field as Santana was on the sideline, but in their own defensive half, the Knights had five men defending. Coach Tommy Tanner's squad didn't realize that Santana was on the ground on their own offensive zone. And they had six men on the field. It appears the referees have noticed it now, as the Baltimore Blast definitely cried out that there were too many men on the field. And keen to it, Rich Grady's staff spotted it. It all started when Nelson Santana had a handball in his own defensive zone that wasn't called by the referees. He scooped it up, went all alone down the right side. And with arms flailing, he was trying to draw a foul on the Blast, but couldn't get it. And he fell on the ground. Undisciplined play by the Silver Knights. They put someone on for Santana, who they thought was off. And they'll pick up a too many men on the field penalty. 2 minutes served by LJ Papaleo with 10 minutes to go in the game. So the penalty kill squad of Manfoot Bojelovic rings off both posts, looking land on a smart blast. And it'll go out of bounds by Antonio Manfoot. So the penalty kill unit of Manfoot, Toby, Domenico Vitale, and Bojelovic on. It goes to Gonzaga. Looking land wants a blast. He'll take it, rings off the top, and it'll bounce all the way out to Gonzaga. On the near side, it goes to Looking Land. Ferdinand, back to Looking Land. Scoops across quickly to Gonzaga. Wide and shot way over the top. He's angry at himself as he lashed it on a curler trying to find the top 90, but really too high. And right now, the Knights have killed off 46 seconds of the penalty. Michelle Millwood controls and holds it up, killing precious seconds. He pokes it out of the hands of William Van Zela, who didn't have the ball. Toby will have it on his left, trying to scoop it across, but Looking Land, on a smart slide, gets it away. Toby will play it all the way back to Bo. Big Bo will lob it up for Michelle Millwood. Controlled by Forbes. Pushed off by Neto, and now Millwood will get it. Plays it off the boards, and Van Zela will scoop it up. Trying to get his men out in front as they have a little under 40 seconds in the penalty. One man advantage. With 8:50 to go in the fourth quarter, leading by one. Ferdinand plays it across to Gonzaga. Gonardo Forbes plays it to his captain. Gonzaga to his captain, rather. He was guarded by Gonardo Forbes. Ball scooped in, and Brian O'Quinn will hold it up, and with 10 seconds to go in the penalty, long throw for Manfoot. He's got tons of pace. He lashes at it, and it's calmly collected by Van Zela. LJ Papaleo can come out right now, and so far it's killed, but Adato Neto fizzes it across the face. Nobody was making that far post run, and it couldn't be collected. Vitale trying to get it out, and O'Quinn, off his line, picks it up. So after a Nelson Santana error leads to a power play, no dice for the Baltimore Blast, just 2 minutes off the clock that are precious for the Silver Knights right now, down by one. Long blast by William Van Zela over the top into the front row of fans. And that'll lead to a restart for the Knights. Down by one. We've got the final 7:47 for you after this media timeout on the floor. We'll be back right after this. Back for the final, 7:47 of this one. The Baltimore Blast lead the Syracuse Silver Knights 8-7 in the fourth quarter. And the ball blasted off. Now knock ahead forward. Neto, Coriolanio on a swift volley. Catches it, but it doesn't test William Van Zela. Max Ferdinand will hold and chest it over to Adriano Dos Santos, but the ball goes out to JT Noon. He'll reload. Now the Blast will have the ball. On the near side to Ferdinand. pushed away by Bojelovic right in front of the referees. Now the ball's clipped in for Diego Zunaga. O'Quinn comes off his line and takes it calmly. Neto takes a swing and a miss. And Pat Healy will control. Ball across the face of goal by Neto. And ball reloads to Nelson Santana. Key minutes here with 6:30 to go. Down by one, the Silver Knights looking to escape an 0-5 record against the Baltimore Blast at their home arena. Long pass trying to find Lucas Roque. It's intercepted by Nate Bordeaux. Leading the other way, it goes for Kanata Forbes. Finding Millwood just off the mark. Didn't find him, but the look was there. Still the ball is held by the Silver Knights. The target man, Michelle Millwood, off the hand of JT Noon, and the Knights will have an opportunity here. So a key opportunity here for the Silver Knights. Bernardo Forbes blasted off of Mike Lookingland, and now he'll reload O'Quinn. Long pass ahead for Millwood, just over the top. And Van Zela will hold the ball for the Blast. Plays it out for JT Noon. Noon goes to Lookingland. Van Zela way up the pitch. Surprised that the Knights aren't pressuring. On the turn is Neto, poked away by Ubiparapovic. And now they'll collect. Nelson Santana will go to the ground, trying to fix his footwear as it fell off the right boot. Long pass ahead to Adato Neto. Goes wide, long blast, off the mark. And he'll go the other way. Coriolanio driving down the middle. He scoots it over to Neto, off the boards, trying to find Elenio running down the middle. But Van Zela will take it away. Bojelovic will play it across to Nelson Santana, edging in on 4:30 to go. In the fourth quarter, the Knights down by one. Ahead. Now it'll be Bojelovic connected and curled in for Neto by Santana. Lookingland will dispossess and loft it ahead for Adriano Dos Santos, who wins a challenge with Nelson Santana. Bojelovic will control on the left side. Just under 4 minutes to go. The entire crowd screaming, "Let's go Knights!" as they try to urge the home squad to earn their eighth victory of the year, equaling last year. On the turn, Michelle Millwood is blocked away by Stephen Daru, and it'll escape all the way to Marco Chantel. Brian O'Quinn's left-footed clearance is knocked out by Tony Donatelli. Now, the Knights will have another opportunity. Trying to head it was Michelle Millwood, but Daru beats him in the air and gives it back to Van Zela. Smart defending, and now the Knights will have an opportunity to reload with Ubiparapovic, Neto, Forbes, Santana, and Toby on the floor for the home squad. played off the boards. Ubi Paripovich wants a shot. He takes it. Ferdinand is there to block. And Lookingland chips it up for more possession for the Knights, who, to be completely honest, look a little out of ideas. But Forbes here, he broke his scoreless streak earlier on in this game, and he'll have an opportunity here. Off the boards by Bordeaux as it caught Vanzela behind his back. He couldn't connect. Long throw, out of bounds. It'll go at the top of the arc. So a keen opportunity here with 2:25 to go in the game. Canardo Forbes, joined by Michelle Millwood on the ball, with Nelson Santana to his left and Big Bo Yelovich on the right. Millwood fakes the shot, and he'll take the timeout. You had to expect it there, as Coach Tommy Tanner will whip out the whiteboard and try to draw up a play. With 2:25 to go, the Knights trail by one. In the fourth quarter, we'll have it here right after this. So with the timeout over, Coach Tommy Tanner's squad has a restart at the top of the arc with 2:25 left in the fourth quarter, down by one. He'll send out Nelson Santana, Slavisa Ubiparapovich, Neto, Bo Yelovich, and Michelle Millwood. The Blast will counter with Pat Healy, Tony Donatelli, Adriano Dos Santos, Mike Lookingland, and Steven DeRue, as Canardo Forbes joins them as the extra attacker. Really bad pass by Slavisa Ubiparapovich, and it leaves a wide open net for Steven DeRue to take a shot. He can't make it, and the ball is taken away on a slide by Nelson Santana to save himself from giving up a goal there. Now Slavisa Ubiparapovich will have the ball and give it up for the Knights, who have an extra man on the field with Brian O'Quinn sitting on the bench. Canardo Forbes takes the extra man jersey as he's joined by the brightest offensive minds for the Knights. On the left foot, shot by Ubiparapovich, pawed away by Vanzela. A key save by Vanzela, the Italian international. It goes to Forbes. He'll swing it wide for Santana, wanting the blast, but gets it across the face, trying to find Michelle Millwood. It's too hot, and with 1:40 to go, the Knights are down by one. Long shot by Nelson Santana. Couldn't find the head of Neto. Millwood has the ball. He'll reload with Forbes. 1:30 to go. Down by one. Ubiparapovich drives on the right channel. Couple scoops, and the ball is clinged out to Canardo Forbes. He'll go wide to Santana, curling over on his right, trying to bring it back. Loose pass, but it's just good enough for Slavisa Ubiparapovich. Coming in on 1 minute. The ball's passed quickly to Santana. He'll hurl it deep, Vanzela, and it'll hit off the top of the bar. Danny Kelly wanted the timeout, but Vanzela threw it quickly. The restart will be at the yellow line, and with exactly 1 minute to go, the Knights have a restart. Down by one. The Salt City supporters section clamoring for a goal. It goes wide, block in front, goal by Yelovich! The deflection is perfection! Bo Yelovich finishes the chance! And with 58 seconds to go, the Knights are up 9-8. The bench clears for the celebration as the Serbian scores his 7th of the year. A timeout for Danny Kelly's squad. Wow. Just what Coach Tommy Tanner's squad needed. Bo Yelovich finishes the chance. And the Knights are up by 1. He went straight to Millwood on that celebration as the restart banged off of a Baltimore Blast defender, and it found the opportunistic foot of Bo Yelovich, who found the back of the net. So Brian O'Quinn will jump back into the Silver Knights goal. Mike Lookingland will put on the extra attacker jersey. And now the Baltimore Blast will go on a man up. With 58 seconds to go, they restarted, and Ferdinand has the ball. It goes to the near side, and Ferdinand on a bad touch. It's given away. Forbes on the shot. It's easily corralled by Lookingland as he puts his hands down and now is able to control. 35 seconds to go. Down by 1 are the Blast. Ferdinand swings it back to his captain. Right back to the headgear of Ferdinand. Swings it back across for Lookingland. On the far side, Lucio Gonzaga. Off the boards, it goes to Pat Healy. Lookingland, to Ferdinand rather. Back to Lookingland, 15 seconds to go. Down by 1, Canarda Forbes, a long blast. It looks like it has eyes for the boat, but it can't go, it's off the post. 5 seconds left, Lookingland lofts it forward. Netto on a touch, 1 second, victory for the Knights. They end their Baltimore curse and defend home court. The Knights win 9-8 after a Bo Yelovich score. Wins the game with a minute left. The Knights move to 8-4 on the year and pull one game back on the two-game lead that the Milwaukee Wave had at the start of the game. And now the Knights have ended their one-game winning losing streak and move it in the other direction, a one-game winning streak. Bo Yelovich, obviously, with the key goal in the game. But also, it's been the smart efforts of Canarda Forbes, who ended his two-game scoreless drought with a goal in the third quarter, a three-point shot. Michelle Millwood scored against his old team. LJ Papaleo opened the scoring in the first quarter. And the Blast are held without a win and end their winning streak here in the Salt City. It stops at 7. Baltimore had won 7 straight games dating back to December 13th with wins against Rochester, Pennsylvania, and Missouri. But it all ends at the On Center War Memorial Arena after a Bo Yelovich score wins the game for Syracuse. Next up for the Baltimore Blast, the same team, the Syracuse Silver Knights, they'll have a chance for revenge at home at the Baltimore Arena on Friday at 7:35 p.m. They also have a game against the other New York squad. Rochester will visit the Baltimore Arena on the 25th, Saturday. As for the Silver Knights, you have to take stock in the fact that this squad beat a top-level team and handed the Baltimore Blast their third loss on the year. That moves their record to 8-3, and they've got this team three more times in their final half of the season. Next up, after the Baltimore rematch on Friday for Syracuse, is a three-game homestand against the Pennsylvania Roar on Saturday at 7 p.m. And this same Blast team at the end of the month and to start February, they'll play the Milwaukee Wave. So after that, the Knights move to 8-4 on the year. Coach Tommy Tanner's squad can go home happy and the fans can leave with smiles on their faces as the Knights have won it. The next time you'll be hearing from me will be on Saturday as the Syracuse Silver Knights take on the Pennsylvania Roar at 7 o'clock p.m. You can get tickets through the Syracuse Silver Knights box office. Check that number out on the Syracuse Silver Knights website at SyracuseSilverKnights.com. Also, keep it locked for more MISL soccer as the Pennsylvania Roar will be playing later in the day.